गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स। नाउ इन द फिफ्थ लेसन लॉयल्टी एंड फेथफुलनेस। इन दिस लेसन वी विल डिस्कस दैट हाउ द लॉयल्टी एंड फेथफुलनेस विल कम इन योर बिहेवियर विद द हेल्प ऑफ अ शॉर्ट स्टोरी एंड विद फ्यू एग्जाम्पल्स। फॉर एग्जाम्पल, डॉग इज द फेथफुल एनिमल फॉर द ह्यूमन बींग एंड दिस इज द बेस्ट फ्रेंड ऑल्सो फॉर द ह्यूमन बींग because it is not having any kind of greed in his heart. So how faithfulness will come in your heart? Faithfulness, trust, honesty and reliability, these are the key points, key features of the loyalty. What is the meaning of loyalty and faithfulness? Loyalty is the way by which we are delivering our duties. Nobody will compel you, nobody will tell you to do the duties, and you will yourself will think that if I will do this, then this will be helpful for others. If we are doing our responsibilities with our wholeheartedly, then this is the loyalty. And the key features which loyalty will be there is faithfulness, trust, honesty and reliability. Faithfulness means if you have belief in somebody's, then you will do for him and you will try to follow his instructions. So this will be the part of loyalty. Next is the trust. You must have a trustworthy heart in yourself. You must believe in somebody else. If he or she is telling something to you, he must believe that. Then honesty means nothing should be the separate part in your mind or in your heart. You should not think about your personal profit always. You should be there for only the duty for delivering your part to the fullest to others persons. Reliability is what? Means somebody can trust on you, somebody can show his or her trust on you. This is called reliability. And all these will be combined together and we can call this loyalty. So key features of loyalty, number one, faithfulness, number two, trust, number three, honesty, and number four, reliability. So these are the key factors with which we should follow and with which we should do the work, and it will be the others means his perception and his belief on you that will be developed with these key factors. Now how loyalty we can develop in ourselves? It demands devotion to one's duty towards others. As I was telling you that if you are delivering your duties sincerely, on time, if you are punctual enough, then definitely other person will think about you and about your behavior. Next is, it is supreme moral quality. Moral quality means nobody will tell you about your duties, about your responsibilities. It is your side that you must think that what you have to do today or this time, how you have to deliver your duties. Only doing the duty is not a good thing. Doing the duty with your best part, that is the main thing. So this is the main moral quality. Loyalty springs from heart, means it will come from your heart, and it will not be taught by others. It is not written in any book, in any copy. It will come from your heart only, and you must believe in yourself that you want to do something for others. Next is loyalty wrapped in love. If we are giving, sharing love and affection to the other persons, then definitely loyalty is there, and it will not need any, it will not ask any money or any other thing from the other person. You are ready to give your fullest, your 100% to the other person. This is called loyalty. Now, dogs are the most loyal. This animal, dog, is the most loyal creature to the human being, to his master. The instruction, whatever his master is giving to the dog, definitely the dog will follow. And on the other side, master is also not harming his dog. This instruction is also for its benefit only. Next is, they are trusted absolutely. And how we can say that dogs are trusted absolutely? Because whatever the instructions dogs are getting, they are trying to do that work by its full heartedly. That dog is not having any kind of greed in his mind. The dog will play you with you. The dog will help you at such instant, and that dog will try to keep safe you also. That dog will certainly be a good friend of you also. So all these kind of things are there in the human being's mind, that dog is a good creature. Now, loyalty stems from the sense of responsibility. If a person is responsible enough, if a person is trying to do its part with his full ability, then definitely loyalty will be there for that particular person or for that particular organization. Means, whatever the work associated with us, we should do it. Means, a person is working somewhere, he should work at its fullest. If a student is there, that student must do his homework, that student must behave properly with his parents, with his teachers, with other peoples. So this is the moral values which we should have. Now, loyalty and responsibility are the two sides of a coin. Both the things are one opposite, we can say. One thing can't stand separately. Both the things are the two sides of a coin. How this is? This is only due to that if the loyalty is there, you will deliver your responsibilities at your fullest. If you are delivering your responsibilities at your fullest, then loyalty is there. Means both the things are the sides of one coin only. Both the things are important, and one thing can't stand with the others. So this we have to take care. If you live your life in a responsible way, it shows you are loyal to God. In a responsible way, how we can live our life? What is the meaning of this? For example, we should not harm the society. We should not do any work which can affect the society, which can disturb any other people. We should do always the things which is good for the human being, for the mankind. And if we are living a good moral, responsible life, then we are loyal to the God. Because God is not telling that we should disturb others. So, responsible life means if we are taking care of our family, if we are taking care of our mother, father, if we are taking care of our society, and we are not doing anything that can harm any society or any particular culture or any particular human being. So, we are loyal to the God, the creator of all. That means the God, the creator of all. You are loyal to your parents when you follow their instructions. This is the main part of this lesson, that if you are following your guardian, your parents, whatever they are telling, you are listening, you are following. So definitely you are loyal to your parents. So this is the loyalty and the responsibility. If your guardian is giving you responsibility, that better do this thing, read this lesson, do the homework, don't play for long time, don't go to his house, take care of yourself. If your guardian is telling you for some responsible things and you are listening to them, you are following them, then this is called loyalty. You are loyal to your parents, you are loyal to your guardian. Your sense of belonging towards your family makes you responsible. 2, protect its honor and prestige. Means, if you are loyal enough, if you are taking care of the words of your parents, then you are loyal to your parents, your family. And what and how it will help you? It will help you in guiding, in protecting the prestige and the respect which they are having in the society. Means if you are doing something wrong, then definitely your guardian will have some kind of shame in his personality. If you are doing good, if you are good in studies, then definitely your guardian, your parents will be praised by the other persons also, and other persons will try to follow you as well. So we must adopt such a behavior that will be helpful for the others and for us too. So in this lesson we will proceed for the next points. For these, this is the loyalty and the faithfulness with a certain examples. It is trying you to make you understand, and this moral science is not only to clear the examination. This moral science is that these things you must keep in your behavior. You must follow your teacher's instructions. You must follow your parents' instructions. You must not do anything that may affect the society. You think always positive for the society. You must do good for others. You must love animals, as animals are also loving human beings. So all these things we must adopt in our behavior. Thank you, students. And you must read this lesson. You read this and you have to maintain the notes as I am giving. Thank you.